We're going to talk about
what the basics are of statistics. This is usually where statistics classes start and give you an idea of why do we do statistics. So first off, what is statistics? And what statistics is it's a study. Yeah, that's such a boring definition. So I'm going to give you a better definition. Statistics is asking questions. About a group. Collecting the data. To find out about the group. And then using the data to answer the questions. So that's really the whole point of statistics. The whole point of statistics is to take data and find out what's going on in the data and what's happening. And find out about some group based off that data. And that's really what we do about this. Now, there's a couple definitions that help us. First off, we have something called a unit of observation. Unit of observation is the person or the object that you're measuring. So it's whoever you measure, it's whatever you measure, it's that object. So it could be a person, it could be a date, it could be a bunch of different things. So just as an example, it could be a date, it could be a person, it could be a dog, it could be a country, and a bunch of other things it could be. So as an example, if I wanted to do a data, to collect data on, or answer the question, how is, and I don't mean to upset anybody by this, but how is the coronavirus doing in a certain country? Then I would go and collect the data and about that country to answer that question. I'd look at how many people have the coronavirus in that country, how many people live in that country, how many people have died from that, from the coronavirus, how many people have a very light reaction to it. All these different things that are information you could collect on it. And so in that case, it would be the country that I would go collect the data on. So my unit of observation would be a country. Once I have my unit of observation, I then have to talk about what am I going to measure off of them. So that's where the variable comes into play. The variable is what we measure from the unit of observation. So in other words, do I want to measure if I look at, let's say, like at Flagstaff, and I want to know what is the salary of people in Flagstaff, then my variable would be the salary of people in Flagstaff. So that's what I would measure. So in that example, it could be salary. It could be height if I'm caring about the height of people. It could be weight if I care about the weight of people. It could be car type, if I want to know what people are buying. It could be eye color, if I care about that. These are all different things it could be that I can measure. So these are all different things I can look at and figure out and deal with. Once I know what I'm going to measure, and who I'm measuring it from or what I'm measuring it from, then we can get the population. And the population is just the set of all values of the variable and I actually don't like the word all there. So it's a set of values of the variable from all units of observation. And the reason I moved the word all is because sometimes it gets confusing about the word all. So it's better to go with the unit of observations for the word all. But it's just a set of values of the variable from all units of the observation. In other words, it's every single number you could collect or variable you could collect from every single solitary unit of observation. So as an example, if I want to do an example of this, I could say it is the salary of all Flagstaff residents. Now, that would be pretty big. That'd be a pretty good size group to go collect from. There's 60 some thousand people, 75,000 people that live in Flagstaff. So it would take a really long to get all that, but it is technically doable, but it would take a lot of money and a lot of time and a lot of effort to actually go and do. Another example would be if I wanted to go into the national forest, let's say Coconino National Forest, and measure the diameter breast height of every single solitary tree, ponderous pine tree in the forest, my population would be the diameter breast height of every single solitary ponderosa pine tree in the Coconino National Forest. That I couldn't do. There's no way I could physically go and measure every single solitary tree, because by the time I finished measuring every tree, they'd all be different trees. They'd be bigger, they'd be new, they'd be less. So it's not a really good idea. So sometimes you can't get this whole population. Sometimes you can do it, it's doable, but it'd take a really long time. Sometimes it's not doable at all. In that case, we do what's called a sample. And a sample looks just like the population. So remember, our population was the set of values of the variable from all units. The sample is a set of values from some of the variables, sorry. From some of the unit of observations. So from some of them, not all of them. So that is what a sample is. So as an example, I could, instead of doing all, so as an example, I could do the set of measure of salaries from, let's say, 1,000 residents of Flagstaff. Thousand still would take you a bit of time, but it's doable. It's not impossible to do. I could, if I wanted to go and measure the diameter breast height of trees in the Coconino National Forest, I could do the diameter of at breast height of 1,000 trees in the Coconino National Forest. And that's doable. And I would also do it only for the ponderosa pine trees, but it's doable to do that. It would still take a lot of time and a lot of money and a lot of effort, but not nearly as much as taking the population. So that's basics, the start of that.